Christ thinks in the nostrils of God. Why are you focusing on what you think is my bad? Because what you don't realize, God is using my bad to help you. God's got so much.
I swear she's preaching. I swear to God she's preaching right now.
My bad is your good. You can learn from me. Why y'all not talking to each other? So you can really learn some things.
You can learn.
But when I mess up, it's on God's schedule for my life. Because I'm God's chosen. And God chastens who he loves. Why do y'all think those of us who try to get out of the way with God, he pulls us right on back in? This is it. Do you not recognize it? Do you not see it? That I'm doing a new thing in the earth, and my prophecy to the earth is now it shall spring forth. How many of y'all are tired of doing the same thing, seeing the same thing? I'm talking to people in ministry. I need people who say, okay, God called me, his hand is upon my life, but seems like my life is at a standstill. Be real with the day, because God came to deliver you. Don't act shy, don't act new. I'm talking about those who are tired of doing the same thing. Tired of when you sing, you hear the same type of anointing. I thought y'all wanted to be real. Whenever you dance and shout, there's really no true victory in your steps.
Why don't you preach? Why don't you preach? Why don't you preach?
You need to be in God. Can I just tell y'all, being that I'm not from Detroit, every time I come to Detroit, I pray for this region. I was riding through downtown today, and I said, there's some governmental wickedness going on. There are people in high places who are having discussions. It's against the work of the Lord. For some reason, I know I hear God. For some reason, the government officials are against God's church.
Come on.
It's too many churches for them. They're not worried about nothing else. They'll keep the casinos up. They'll keep everything else going. They'll make sure everything else is functioning. But when it comes to church, it's somebody in position who don't want to see the church of the Lord grow. That's why the people of God cannot come in church and play games. We got to rally together. That's why we can't afford to be negative. We got to see the good in everybody. We can't sit in the pew and judge who's doing good, who's doing bad. No, get behind everybody. Pray for everybody. I don't care what you mean, you know. Some of y'all know too much because you're nosy. Some of y'all know too much because you seek for it. Why do you seek for the mess? Because there's so much about you that you don't like that you told you to see who else is jacked up. You want to be in familiar company. Let me find out who else is doing bad, because I'm doing so bad. Instead of me praying and getting delivered and praying for them, let me find out who else is doing bad so I feel good in my mess. You're walking in confusion. Somebody shout out, heal me, God. Take for a million and let heal my heart. Change my heart. God, help me to move forward. Judgmental spirit. Always looking for something. Walking in depression because you don't sound like somebody. Walking in confusion because your gift don't act like somebody else's. The devil is a lie. Don't you understand that God is too creative to have to repeat himself in you? There's already a TV judge. You just be who God called you to be.
Why don't you preach?
You be whoever God called you to be.
Why don't you preach today? You preaching good.
If you modulate by accident, just go with sincerity.
It's okay. Preach on this morning.
You know what happened? We got addicted to those two words, do you. We got addicted. The church has adapted to so many worldly things until we cannot differentiate who we are. We have so many worldly attributes until the church and people in the world have to set the second list. They're doing a Scooby-Doo, huh? They're trying to figure out who are they. Oh, y'all church? Y'all wearing the same thing they wearing in the club. Let me preach some holiness right quick. Are y'all the church? Y'all curse just as much as the people in the world. Are y'all the church? Y'all just as messy as everybody else in the world. Where is the church?
You are preaching good.
Would I be safe in that environment?
I swear. where she preaching today. You are in this house. I'm going to tweet that today.
Listen to me, Satan.
If you was the church, would I be able to call you?
There is a paradigm shift that is happening in the earth. And a paradigm, let me tell you something about what it is. A paradigm is our perception of reality. Say, a paradigm is our perception of reality. If y'all push me, I'll get through. I said, a paradigm is our perception of reality. It is our view of the world and our interpretation of events based on previous stuff we've already received. That's what it is. Okay. And so, if our paradigm is based only on our input from the media, magazines, radio, television, Hollywood, public education, to truly know, can we really be helped by God? Some of y'all have more Facebook colloquialism than the Bible. Some of y'all Facebook professionals. Some of y'all having a twitch right now because you want to get your phone and scroll. Look at you. I'm praying for you. Some of y'all don't know what to do with yourself right now. I need my phone. God, where's my phone? Give me my phone. Some of y'all got your phone in your hand. You can click on the Facebook at any given time. We got to get off of Facebook and face the book. We got to turn off Twitter.
That will preach. That will preach.
What we really truly hear from God is because with this much information on Facebook, I like that plan.
Because you preaching good. You preaching too good for them to hear. Lord have mercy.
I'm talking to us as a body of Christ. This ain't no y'all gospel. I'm preaching to us gospel. This word is for us in here. I'm not passing judgment. I'm talking about us together. We all want to help each other to get better. Some of us don't want to help nobody get better because we're not done developing. You know why some of us can't celebrate each other? Because we know we're not where we should be. And we are so afraid in our flesh that if we say amen one time too many, that God's going to forget about us. Real friends. I don't like nothing Y'all talk back to me. I like funny people. Just don't waste your time speaking to me if you don't like me. I'm good.
Don't waste your time speaking to me. Don't say two words.
That's not Christian life. What are you talking about? It's called discernment. Everybody is, should not be able to touch you. So when that spirit man is
open, everybody can't touch you.
To your spirit. Why do you think some of y'all don't have to eat with people in the next few days? You talking like them, you laughing like them, you thinking like them, because your spirit man is not strong enough to be around them. So you become them.
I swear you're preaching on today.
We need a paradigm shift. Say, we need.
We need.
A paradigm.
A paradigm.
Shift.
Shift.
That means that our perception needs to change. Our understanding needs to change. And it needs to change suddenly. That means that we need to come to ourselves. Right. Those of us that don't do the truth, we're already in trouble with God because we know the truth.
Right.
And you know why some of us don't do the truth? Because it's not popular enough. It ain't enough people doing it. It's going to make us have a sense of responsibility that our flesh has told our spirit man to be afraid of. And I'll say it again. Some of us know to do the truth, but because of the people that we hang around, see, y'all tell the truth. Some sin, it just is fun to do.
That is the truth. That is the truth. Some sin, huh? Y'all living in sin.
Some sin is fun to do. That's what y'all looking to do. That Jamie Kirk was good now. Some stuff is fun to do over and over and over again. Over. But it comes a time that if you say you don't belong to you, that you have to accept that you belong to God. And they get comfortable doing what he wants.
Come on.
I want y'all to take a leap of faith and turn to two or three people and say, it's time.
It's time.
For us to do what God wants. Can I ask y'all a question?
No,
that
you
if
don't.
You're in your house and somebody in your house that you don't know, you gonna let them just come in and go in your refrigerator?
Don't touch my refrigerator. Don't touch my refrigerator.
If somebody was walking by and they don't know you, you don't know them, are you gonna let them just come in and go in your bedroom and sit down?
Don't go in my room either. You're going to start a fight.
Y'all going to go get black? Huh? Okay. Oh, you're going to be some trouble. Right? Okay. So that means you don't let anybody just come in your house and do what they want.
They can't do it. Not in my house.
So do you think, how do you think God feels that you walk in his house?
Come on. And do whatever.
He said, enter into his gates.
With thanksgiving.
So why are we begging you? Come on and give him praise. Come on and lift your hand. Come on and get on your feet. You need God's help. We shouldn't have to ask a person who God has salvaged, saved, blocked from getting shot, paid bills.
Come on.
To praise him. When we're in God's house, we owe him that.
We owe him that.
I owe God a few things.
I want to take just a minute to see what you owe him. Go for it. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. Now use your hands more than you do with your mouth. Come on. Out of the mouth, but until the heart speaks. What your mouth got to say to your God? You're in this house. Say something to God. Your deliverer, your peace giver, your mind regulator, the lover of your soul. Protector.
Yes, Lord.
The keeper.
Yes, Lord.
The healer. Say something. Say something to him. Forget about who's around you. Just for a minute. We're in God's house. It might not be foreign to you. Worship is going to happen. Giddy up. It just happens. Hallelujah to your name. We glorify you. We magnify you.
We give you glory, Lord God.
Yes, God, not keep him from giving what he deserves. The winds are changing. Shift is happening in the earth. God's voice is about to be heard louder than what you know. Saints of God, let's not wait until another incident happens for us to believe that God is talking. Why can't we accept that God will send the little lady from Houston to come here to tell you that you're on his mind? Why? Some of y'all immediately say, oh, I'm glad I'm on God's mind. So he, I know he's going to pay all my bills. I'm so glad I'm on God's mind. He's going to touch my whole family. I know God's going to provide for me. I'm so glad I'm on God's mind. And that God going to do so and so. Some of us on God's mind because he's waiting on us to obey. And he's trying to make a decision to not either cut you off or give you more grace. Y'all want to hear this?
Come on. You preaching for real. You teaching today.
How much more grace should I give this disobedient child of mine? Think about us in the human. How many times you gonna tell little Charlie to come inside and he don't come inside? You only one time, hey, come inside, it's getting dark. I need old schoolers now. The second time around, hey, y'all come inside. Third time, yeah.
That belt came out. That belt came out.
I asked you two times to come. And the third time, you made me go beyond what I allow for grace over your behind. Because I asked you to come inside. And on the third time, now I got a whoop here. Ain't no question alive. Well, let me get this. Yeah, duck if you want, but it's about to be real good. Go on and get the A&B ointment because it's going to be some bloodshed. The skin is fixing to get ripped. That's what's wrong. We quit whipping children. I'm not going to go there in a minute. We stop whipping children. Some of us are just as crazy as we want to be right now as an adult because we didn't get enough whippings. I understand. Come see me at the church. I can always catch you.
I got so many whoopings. I got so many whoopings for no reason. I got whoopings for no reason, for thinking wrong. I got a whooping for thinking wrong.
There comes a time that he says, how much more grace must I extend to you after you saw me block you from the car wreck? You saw me let you get home after the home invasion. You saw me give you a raise when everybody else was being laid off. How much longer must I wait for your total obedience before I go ahead on and prove that I'm an angry getting God? I can get mad too. I'm a sovereign God. Are you going to love me just the same? Sometimes God can't whip us because he knows we don't love him enough to take the whip and keep loving him.
You just preach something right there. You preach something
so
right there.
The whipping off. I came for somebody. They ain't going to say nothing. He holds the whipping off so you can continue to love him because he knows how much danger you will be if you change your mind about loving him. So sometimes when you get deeper in God, the whippings begin because he can trust you at this point to take from him what you need. How many of y'all had a time, Mama, they whip you and then hug you afterwards? You were mad, but you ran straight to her arms. Straight there. That's what God wants. Can you take the whipping? Oh, this is too heavy for some of you. Let me just go. Let me stick for
some.
Yeah. All right. There's an author by the name. Oh, it's gonna be trouble now because I'm coming at my heels. Bring my house shoes now. I'm done being cute now. Okay. But some of y'all gotta lay my hands on. Because y'all don't want to give this word. I'm not mad, I'm concerned. Because when we come to church and continue to come to church faithfully, when we come to church and don't change, Lord, help me preach this.
Serve tonight, serve.
When we come to church and don't change, God gets insulted.
Yeah. Woo!
I said, we come to church, get into worship, and by the time we hit the back door, there is no change. God gets insulted. He says, I let you come into the presence of people so that you would get a little boost to whatever it is you need to be better. But then you decide, after your booster shot, that you don't really want this relationship work. And you hit the door, and before you can get to the door, the spirit of carnality jumps on you. You've already texted two or three people in the church for y'all to go somewhere and eat and discuss church. I'll wait.
Won't you preach? Won't you preach?
God is not going to continue to allow you to come to church the same. discuss each other and return. He's not going to allow you to remain repeat offenders. Because God is tired. Some of y'all worry about the pastor's business. It's not your business.
Not even your business.
Some of y'all have even followed this car. Please don't make me come with you. I'm trying to stay behind the pulpit. People who are insensitive to the work of God. Your hate is causing you to hinder the servant. Don't occupy the first and second rows if you come to spectate, speculate, text, and repeat. God sees it.
Come on.
Just so you think nobody saw. We ain't gotta see it. God sees it. And there's about to be some changes. Oh my God. I see why it took me so long to come, because there's a shift that's about to happen with this ministry. God's gonna expand and bless it. And he has his hand on, he's got to heal some things first. But y'all are not God. Doesn't matter, you're not God.
You're not God.
You have the responsibility that God has. All he wants you to do is pray and keep the peace. Quit coming and looking at what the first lady got on, what the pastor's doing, the body language of the sisters, and this, that, and the third. Some of y'all are running your mouth too much. Woo!
Talk in this church house. Come on.
Quit showing up to be a hindrance.
Come on.
Because if God wanted you to pastor, he'd have chose you.
Lord, have mercy. Yeah. You are preaching in this house.
There's no way that you can sense what is wrong unless you have a remedy for what's right. How do you call out what is wrong if you don't know what's right? You got to compare it to something. Some of y'all on the praise team trying to outdo each other. What are you trying to do?
You gotta talk.
We are not even extending joining together. We're supposed to be supporting each other. We're supposed to be praying for each other, not trying to outdo each other. Who can sing the loudest? Who's gonna impress the pastor? Who's gonna find and get his attention? For what?
Yeah. Woo, you preaching in his house. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Bind it up.
In the name of Jesus.
Bind it up. If there are members when his dad was alive, was waiting for him to fail, I bind it up. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
He ain't like pastor. He ain't supposed to be. God chose him. If you don't believe in his anointing, find you somewhere else to be.
Preach in his house.
He's going to move as God has called him to move. He's going to say what God has called him to say. Some of y'all are listening to me say this word and you still judging. I'm looking at you this morning.
Yeah.
You don't think I see that spirit in you?
Yeah.
Walk from church to church.
Yeah.
But you want somebody to impress your praises.
Preach in this house. Preach in this church.
Boa constrictors. Some of y'all be careful who you talk to after church.
Yeah, yeah.
Wrap their mind around you and suffocate
everybody. Yeah, yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Quit talking to everybody.
Can't talk to everybody.
The conversation will get around your neck and you won't be able to breathe. You'll begin to look like them, act like them. Y'all coming to church dressed just alike and you ain't known each other for 2 months.
My God.
I bind the devil up. I said, I bind him up. I came to cover my brother today. I bind the devil up. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
He has a work to do. This world is in trouble, sis. We've got to come together. I brought some of the preacher, kept asking God, why do you keep interrupting what I'm studying? Why do you keep interrupting it? Look at all of this youth back here. Look at all of this youth right here. There used to be a time when they wouldn't even come to church. Why are you knowing what God is doing? Look at all these young minds. Look, I don't care what you think. Oh, they just trying to be like women. They trying to dress like him. Oh, they just as loud as him. They ain't nothing but a bunch of fans. So are you. That's why you're showing up.
You are, I promise you, you are preaching. You are preaching.
And look close to me now, I ain't no fan. You're the opposite of a fan. You're a naysayer. You don't love God like you want to act like you want people to believe in. You may not, I ain't no fan. You may not be a fan. It's not a requirement. It's a hindrance, actually.
Uh-huh.
God said, whatever you believe you are in God, we will not have to wonder about it. And it ought to be so evident that we show up to see it.
Oh.
Be so evident over your life that we're looking to sit next to you in church.
Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy.
You love it.
You preach it.
You
preach it.
That's why you stay frustrated. That's why you stay in people's ear and bind you up today in Jesus.
Come on. Because they in the house today.
As she cursing the people, yes, you just know that God got whoever you put on your mouth to already set to receive you and rebuke you again.
Again.
You preach. Preach this house.
Jesus is coming. Tell me, hashtag that. Jesus is
coming. Hashtag that. Jesus is coming.
It's time to give God a true and sincere yes. We got all these clicks. Sometimes the pastor got to have support that looks like a click because we don't understand how much of our hindrance hurts him.
Exactly.
Come here.
He may never hear you say what you say, but it does not stop him from feeling what you say.
Come on.
Remember, you're the one that he prayed for even when you're jealous about his elevation.
Wow.
Don't you understand that it's a conflicting, prophetic spirit that you have been addressed and come to church to be a hindrance?
Come on and preach. You are preaching.
You are preaching.
It's not his nature.
God.
It's not Christian. It's not the true love of Christ. You need to be healed, be set free, and be delivered. Somebody clap your hands like we're in a tarrying service. Somebody shall save me again.
Save me again.
Come on, save me again. I came to help somebody. Because some of y'all are playing games thinking God doesn't see you, that he's not sensing you. You're trying to ignore that God sent me for you. You're leaving in your car and you won't make it to your next destination. The last time God put me here, I was in New Orleans, Louisiana about 22 years ago. And I was asking God, why are you doing this? I came here to be at a concert. I began to prophesy. And I saw somebody in the audience and I was too afraid. I was young in the ministry, in the prophetic. I was unfamiliar. So I was afraid to say anything to him. And I was like, I keep seeing this. God, please help me. I was young. I didn't know what I wanted to call his name. Hey, brother, I see so-and-so. And God said so-and-so. So I spoke, you know, vastly. God says this and God says that and run to him. And the altar is open. Those of you tonight that you're struggling, come and do so-and-so. And I pleaded and I pleaded. And I knew I was getting on the people's nerves because it was a musical. They didn't come there for that. But I was the last one up. So I said, y'all, please come. I get a call, y'all, at 5 a.m. the next morning. I get a call from the pastor of the church. Because I told him who God has shown me.
Yeah.
He called me crying. I said, what's wrong? I said, calm down. I said, what's wrong? He said, so-and-so left the church meeting, went down, somebody walked up to him, cut his throat from ear to ear.
Wow.
Shot him several times and left him in his Escalade. 5,000 people showed up to a funeral of a life that really could have been saved.
All right.
Y'all, God was real. I don't have to try to scare anybody. I don't have no agenda. I'm trying to get the church to wake up. We have been blinded by flesh.
Yeah.
We have been so caught up in who we think we are.
Yes.
We're waiting for some type of elevation that ain't even assigned to us. Some of us have been anointed to be behind the scenes.
Come here.
Because you feel like your name ought to be called. Some people don't like to give until their name is called. This ain't no flesh glories in my sight.
Yeah.
None of it.
Yeah.
No pleasure in it. Y'all, listen to me. Whatever this section is, the section over here that sings the praise and worship? Oh, yeah, I see. Raise your hand looking at me, y'all. Listen to me, y'all. God wants to use this place. You are chosen. You heard? But you chose
him. Work, work, work.
You've been through a lot. Stuff you ain't ever told.